Alright. I am back today to try and... Well, it's the same day. I want to finish these puzzles. So I have... Boom. I have the last two from iDventure. This one is the Trial of Camelot. And then I have the other one is the Cambridge Labyrinth. This is the last one. So first I'm starting with this one. And again, I've not really looked at these two in depth. They're very intricate. It feels very, yeah, everything just feels very precarious. So first, I'm going to do this first. I did it at the end of my first stream. I'm going to go ahead and do it now for this one. These are the puzzles I'm going to share in the chat. And then this is the channel I'm using for my music. It is Lo-Fi Geek. No copyright, just lo-fi music I use for background streaming if I'm doing something that isn't a video game, or if I need it for me for background, if I need to concentrate and focus on something, whether studying, work, things like that, I like to listen to them. But yeah. So here is my Trial of Camelot. So let's just kind of glance over real quick. We've got the top here. It says start. Start. I'm going to shuffle this out of the way. Hopefully you can still hear me well enough. So this is the top. There's a lot of moving bits. We'll look at this side first. This one looks like a door, which is pretty neat. Got some torches. A lot of very loosely fitting moving parts. A lot of symbols. Oh, it looks like maybe I'll get like some puzzle pieces put in here with like some view holes to give me specific symbols or something. This is wicked. A lot of chains going in all kinds of directions, like to connect things. Oh, I just realized there's sort of wheels on the edges. That's pretty cool. This looks like king and queen chess pieces, kind of. And some other various symbols. Not gonna get into much of this yet. Okay, that's all the sides. And the bottom is interesting. Have this sort of rotating rings, concentric rings. Not quite sure what to do with those. Yeah, they don't fully rotate. I assume I'll unlock that at some point. Oh, may not be rings, but like paths to follow, because it looks like they connect to these like castles, different castle symbols. So you see they have a line, so I'm sure the lines line up somehow. So let's go to the top, to the start. So so this is kind of crazy. So it looks like each of these four these three tabs look like they slide in and out. So this, you need to slide K Can't slide any further that way. Or can I? There we go. Okay. Slide this up. Oh boy. Slide this one down. This is all over the place. I don't know what the goal is to get them all to the center. Oh, aha, yeah, there we go. So these three need to go into the center. So you can see I got these sort of have this little pattern you gotta get through in order, you gotta get them to a complete end just to get it to where these three pieces can slide in. So it allowed me to rotate this far enough for these. So let's push these all in and then, oh, I'm gonna be very careful not to do that. I don't wanna mess it up. I want to be able to slide it right back on later. How did that come? How did that unlock? Oh, okay, I gotcha. It's got like a little lip under here. Just kind of latch in. All right. Does this come out already? No, this is stuck by here. And you can see this moving as I try and pull this out. Okay, what is the next step? Okay, so we got this is where my brain fails me. It's telling you, hey, castles, it's not just for decoration. It's saying castle line to castle. That is what we saw on the bottom, where I have to line up these castles with lines. So, let's see. So here, okay, so these, well, this castle is missing a flag on the top. What am I supposed to be doing? So it's like a, do I have to match that? Because it's like a triangle flag with a banner. Oh, that's clever. That's clever. So triangle flag, round window, split door. We got a triangle flag, round window, but not a split door. Triangle flag, split door. Oh. Triangle flag. Nope. Nope. Okay, so it could either be triangle flag, split door, triangle flag, round window, but these have. Oh, this is really hard. Has like a corner missing, so I can see it has the triangle flag at the top and a round window, but I don't know what the door is. And same thing with this triangle flag, the split door, but I don't know what the window is. So I'm looking for triangle flag, round window, split door, matching with the banner flag, square or rectangle window, and the door without a split. So the first one's going to be one of those, and I don't know which yet. But then the other, banner, square, and door, no, maybe. No, maybe. Okay, so these two are maybes. Okay, one of these, one of these. So let's see, and this doesn't rotate all the way. Let's go here. I would show, but there's not a whole lot to show here. Just me fizzling around. Okay, so let's see. One of these to one of these. So let's see, a line here. That doesn't line up. Line here. That lines up here. Doesn't really line up. I think maybe that one. Let's try this route. So holding this in place. Gotta leave it here. Holding this one in place. Up there and here. Let's see how far this rotates around. No. Hey, that lines up. So this is gonna be tricky. I don't know if you can see, I've got a line going from this castle to this one. So, if I'm right, is it this? Oh, that's cool. It's a sword. Kind of. It's basically a sword. Does that unlock it freely? Okay, and then I can rotate it to here. Oh, nice. Oh, that's a lot of cool stuff. It's actually got some arrows, some people symbols in there. A lot of stuff going on. That was kind of cool. So this came out of here. Okay, so that didn't affect it. Okay, I thought I saw some arrows somewhere. These arrows right here, there are some arrows on the inside. So it looks like I pull those apart and that might release something. That doesn't release one thing at a time. flip it over. And pull. Ooh. Oh, okay. Where did those come from? Oh, do those come from in here?
Oh no.
Oh no. I don't know. I think they were. Oh no. Are these identical? No. They're not. Hmm. Well, I need to figure out how they went in. Okay, well, there's one. That's entirely accurate. Well, I can't get my fingers in there very well. Okay, well, that's kind of how it goes, I suppose. So these have like little stars and some holes on them. Do they go in here somewhere? Oh, ho 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 ho. Check this out. Does that look familiar? Right, but I don't know what to do with those yet. Ooh, these move now. Come out, or if I'm not doing this right. I don't want to break it. It's like defines everything in any of their puzzles. Maybe I'm supposed to lift up just enough to see what's underneath it. Something else from somewhere, and I don't know what. that's cool. Wood gears are always really cool and also troublesome. Oh boy. So I guess there's gotta be something here. Am I supposed to? Okay, I gotcha. That is tricky. I'll try and show this off, but so there's these sliding bars, but they have like people playing tug of war. Let me get this lined up. There we go. But see, the top one has one person either side, so it's in the middle. The second one only has one person, so it's all the way that way. And the third one is all the way on the other side because there's only one person. Once you get those lined up, then there's these holes you look through. And it looks like they each have a symbol. And it's very hard. That's where I shine a light in where the eye is so I can see what the symbols are. So that connects to, I guess that's supposed to be this one, so I need like a, I guess that's a kind of an M. This one's, okay, so that is also an M. Oh, that's an X. That's hard to see. Okay. Does that free up this? Oh boy, please tell me this doesn't come apart. That's what I hate about those. I love the puzzle boxes. A lot more companies do them and sell them, but they're usually kits. So it's like, assemble this and then take it apart. I don't want to assemble it. I don't want to see the mechanisms before. Let me write those down real quick. I don't want to see the mechanisms before I actually try and solve it, because that kind of like looking, you know, behind the curtain. Just okay, that's to help me reassemble it later. Okay. So, what have we got next? I can kind of see inside. This is still kind of just free floating. Can't really do anything with that yet. Let me flip it. Okay, I don't know what to do with these pieces yet. I mean, they're right here, but is there a key to insert them anywhere? Does that move? No. Okay. I mean, is there something else to this one? There is something in there that I can see, but it's really hard to see in there. I don't know if it's something I should be doing right now, or if that's later. Let's see if we can, what we can do here. Wait, these. Yeah, these are the symbols that are on here. So I feel like I need to do, I need like pieces. So, no, that doesn't line up. I think this one was this side. Yeah, that looks like it lines up. This one, we're gonna go like something like this. No, not quite. Maybe like this. There we go. Okay, so that's how those, I mean, those are lined up. I don't know what that means, though. And these kind of, like, shift up and down. I don't know what those mean yet. I need to... There's the arrow. There's something else moving in there. No, not that I can tell. There's a very, very fine, like, keyhole with just a very small... I don't think I have anything small enough for that. Seriously, I got it stuck now. Come on, slide you. Cause this was on this side. Oh, where's my stylus? Oh. That's so cool. So I'm taking this piece, and since this one came from the right side, I take and I push it over here. And then I take the torches and they push up. So it allows for, that's so crazy. I love that. Like, I had to figure out a puzzle to release the keys and figure out how the keys work to release the next part. Okay, so does that do something with these two? No. No. Okay. So let's get this out. The other one out. Maybe. Come on. Come on, big guy. There you go. Okay. So with that out, can this move yet? No, I'm slowly getting there. Got this one left. This one, I need something here to solve it. Missing a piece? So it looks like I start this way, so I go 1, 1, 2, 3, 4. So I got like I don't have anything even remotely that shape to like fit in there. But I don't think I have anything that like, yeah, none of these are like squared edges. They're all jagged. This, I'm not getting what this is. Like a pentagon, like a three-leaf clover, and then a moon. Does that mean anything over here? No. Symbols, but these are all what's in here. I feel like I need that piece out, but I don't know how to get it out. I don't want to force it. No, nope, it's not going to come that way. Has to be it. This is just a very, very fine fit. Diamond, there's a pentagon, the cross, and then I called that the three-leaf clover earlier. Cross, diamond, pentagon, three-leaf clover. These are all shapes. Pentagon, clover, cross, diamond. So I need to figure out how this goes in here that makes one visible to give me the other symbol. Okay, so here's the diamond. Diamond is this weird, I don't know, peach shape. We're gonna get out the trusty old pin. Okay, so that's a terrible diamond. Diamond. Shape is. That's what we'll call it. So I need, it's going this way, so I need diamond. Three leaf clover. Cross. I'm going to draw a 3D cross. I'm just putting a T. And then a pentagon. See where does this fit? This only fits so many places. So here's the pentagon. Is this weird like bow shape? And we need, where else does it fit? Cross and clover. The clover, basically a squiggly. And then the cross. Come on, come on, come on, come on, buddy. There you go. Itchy nose. Cross. Now that's a question. Cross. But I need a cross. Let's see, maybe. So we can just rotate around. If I find something that looks like it'll fit. I don't think that's gonna fit anything. It's gonna be this circle. I don't know. Pentagon is this like little bow tie thing. So it's either gonna be this weird like figure eight shape, or like a cursive H. Let's come back and let's see what we got to work with. So, figure eight thing and the cursive H. So, let's just put one. See, those are too close. So it's gotta be these two. And it doesn't fit this way, so. Doesn't seem to fit that way either. Oh, there we go. Okay.
That's my stylus.
This guy, not this guy. Okay. Gotta be careful with splinters. Okay. How did this go in here, though? Okay, it went like that. So, let's see if I can go ahead and put this back in here. That's too tight of a fit. So that's back in. Just preemptively. So we got weird moon shape and a squiggly line. Cursive H. No, not cursive H. Figure eight. Okay. And that's the cursive weird cursive H. No. The other, the bow tie looking one. Okay, so. Make sure these are lined up because they're kind of not very secure. No. Where do I turn it? I turn it first. And then there we go. Do I turn it back? Or does that not come out? Is that the final piece? got like a musical note. Two little rings, another musical note. And So it's saying to unlock. So this is the unlock. This is the lock. Do I need a key? Prizes inside. So saying the quarter note, or sorry, eighth note is the unlock. And I got everything here, right? Nothing about music. Nothing else? Wood. Nothing else inside. Get that back out of the way. Can I use... Ooh. No. That doesn't do anything. So this is the little sword thing. This pops out. And then I've got two parts. Does this fit in here? No, that'd be too cool. This is cool. Maybe that's upside down. Spin around. No. Does this fit? Not really. I thought there was another keyhole. Somewhere. Yeah, right here. That's way too tiny for anything I've found. Oh, that's just for light. Oh. Oh, geez, is that what I was supposed to do? Oh wow, that makes it so much easier. You're supposed to look through that keyhole. I was looking backwards and the angle didn't quite work right. I think that's all I need from there. And this has to be the key. I don't know if this is saying to unlock. I need the key and to pull out, or I have to pull while I try to unlock it. The two rings, though, that's interesting. I don't know what that could be for. It is very dark in there. Wait, I'm an idiot. Let's Let's get this out of the way for a second, temporarily. I'll be able to pull this way. Put this key back in here. I think I legitimately have to rotate it like a key. Hitting whatever the contents are in there too. Going that way. Am I supposed to look through these holes? I'm gonna try. Well, I can't even get it in there. So close. Got to the very end. Am I supposed to blow in it? Is that why? This is true. It's gonna be stupid. Holy crap. That is absolutely nuts. Oh, jeez. Oh, they're swords. Swords. Of course, it's a website. To go on. I feel like it needs to fit into something. Or do I have some letters somewhere? Okay, here's some symbols. Did I see symbols like that somewhere? No. Something.com, something.net, and something.org. It says .com, and they say .net and .org. need something with letters. I don't have any other letters anywhere. Or shapes. There's a diamond. Or just an O. Let's just start trying stuff. I don't know for sure what that's supposed to be. COLUTH.com. No. That's a GALATH.net. Gotcha. Okay. So, it was a process of elimination. If I didn't have a way to confirm it and verify it, I wouldn't have figured it out. But so, it's got left. So it says, like, this flag, hourglass, and greater than symbol, but right to left. These need this. So we've got those symbols right to left. So if we look at it like this, I have G and C, A and O, L, A U U, A E U, and then T and then H. So I thought, so the way I initially did it was I tried this way was first. So this one doesn't have anything in this slot, so I did C-O-L-U-T-H. That didn't bring up anything. Now if I did as far this way, as far this way as I could with the available letter, is G-A-L-A-T-H, and then .net, the farthest one. So that brought up my congratulations website. Galat, the Trial of Camelot. Dear strangers, about 1500 years ago, Sir Galahad, the greatest of the Knights of the Round Table, was the first to pass the Trial of Camelot. After this event, our founder, Mage Merlin, swore that whoever repeated Galahad's feat would be accepted into the Association of Magicians Creators. By getting to this page, you have proved that you are worthy to become a follower of Merlin and create magic objects. Please leave your feedback, blah, 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 blah. Yeah. So that took me right at about an hour. Oof. Little bit longer than I would like. Alright, so now putting it back together. So normally whatever's inside I take out and keep, because it's usually like fridge magnet or something. Occasionally, could I have done it like that? Well, I guess you stack them going up to the top. That probably makes more sense. Anyway. Yeah. So normally I would keep it, take it out and keep it, but like this, I'm going to leave in. This went this way. Okay, so now I got to blow on the other side. And it's locked. That's so silly. I love it though. I love that. Cause I apparently need to start thinking more, like, because it's, I mean, it's the shape of a horn. It's like music, play a note, or yeah. It took me longer than I would like to come to that conclusion. Alright, so what's this for though? I want to know what this is for, because this looks cool. Like, I should be able to use it for something, right? I guess that was supposed to just be assembled like that the whole time. Alright. What was the last thing I took out? There we go. Oh, I don't have it unlocked again. Two squiggly line. There we go. Now let's rotate back, pull these all to the outside. I think that's how it was. Okay. This was this one. Oh boy, I gotta put these back in. That was a clever contraption. I'd like to think that this gives me ideas on like how to make my own, but I'll never make my own. I'd love to. I would love to get into designing things like this, but they're just beyond me. Okay. Now, this is the tricky part, getting this back in under here. That goes that way. This is supposed to go this way. Appreciate that it adds a level of depth. I am not super fond of these sp- spring contraptions in hard to get to places. And it goes like this. Because my fingers don't fit in here. Okay, let's inch it down one side at a time. Well. Okay. They're in there. They're a little lopsided, but I think they'll stay. I don't want to shake them out because they're hard enough to get back in. Okay. Let's do this guy. Oh boy. Okay. Well, let's gotta like resolve it again. Do I have to look at it this way? I think that was, I'm just gonna have to do this from memory. I think this was an X. I think this was, oh wait, no, I can see them. I can see the openings, never mind. I'm stupid. Ignore me. Oh, I had them right, I just am looking upside down. This must go this way. That's good. Right. I think this is next. Oh, jeez. Cool. Okay. No, I just royally screwed that up. I need this and then that one does not move very much. Okay. Did that, was that the sword? I guess that's all that's left. Come on. Come on. Come on. That was it, right? Yeah. Sure, I have these lined up perfectly. Come on. I got it right. Oh, this is shifting. Come on. There we go. Jeez.
Okay, kind of scrim that a little bit.
Okay. Now for the top, which hopefully should not have moved.
Get back in there.
That's not right. Okay, pull these out. Like a good starting point. This is very loose. Done. That took me like another 15 minutes just to reassemble it. Hi, whoever that is. Hope you like puzzle boxes. Alright, that was once again The Trial of Camelot by iDventure. And I'm going to set this aside and swap it out for the next one, which is the Cambridge Labyrinth. Now this one, I don't think this one disassembles like a lot of the previous ones because of this acrylic outer shell on every face. There's a lot going on here. Again, I have not even looked at it before. So, let's take a tour of the labyrinth. We got the top here, lots of spinning wheels. Oh boy. There's like steel balls. Oh man, so it's probably like the actual labyrinth, like with the puzzle balls. Trying to go through like while balancing it perfectly. Oh, this one's gonna be an entirely different experience. Okay, well first things first, let's look for before I make myself look stupid. Yeah, let's look for the word start right here. So start, oh, that's a little awkward with the reflection and glare. Okay, it's not star, it's not strat, start. Do I keep going? Does it release? No? I don't know if this is actually supposed to do anything or just showing me an example. But it's pointing up here like I should have a ball release. So open up this channel to make the ball fall through. Okay, and then I've got, oh boy, square plus sign, star, triangle, circle. And a lot of things here. Supposed to line this up. It's kind of hard to tell what to line up what with what. I'm not supposed to have a ball to start with, right? Oh, oh. Where'd the ball come from? Okay. Well, fun to watch. This doesn't rotate all the way. Okay, there we go. Okay. Well, I've got it kind of out here. This is gonna be crazy. Where do I need to go? And why? There's like multiple areas, but it's like they each have their own puzzle with them. I guess we'll just go to the nearest, easiest place. Oh. Well, I can't, so I guess we won't go there. Let's do this. Can't do that. So there was only one way to go. So now it's down over here. I really hope this one's still not just a maze. Oh, okay. Well, that's locked. So that answers my question. I was afraid it was just going to be like a ball maze. Okay. So, what have we got? Numbers that don't move. This one moves. This one moves. Here, but it looks like the mechanism to release it is locked by maybe something over here. So I probably need to figure out the numbers. And the bottom looks like that's where it opens at the end. So okay. That's a lot of numbers. Let's see if we can find a pattern. So it's zero. What happened? Why did these suddenly move? Does come out. It has an arrow pointing up. So let's see, 0, 1, 2, 3. So if it starts with 0, these only go up to 3. If it starts at 1, they only go to 4, unless... Is this 0? Making this 1? Making this, so if that's 0, 1, 2, 3, this would be 3, 4, 5, 6. This one only goes up to 5, this one goes up to 7, 8. So that is very interesting. 2 to 5, 0. This is just numbers, so it makes no sense yet. Can't line them all. See, now they're... Oh. I don't know what caused it to stick. There's the number, they don't even line up. I'm guessing this has to be my next one, because then it looks like it releases it into the next area. That was weird. My audio kind of crackled a little bit. Okay. Careful of these little splinters.
I like how they it uses a ball to unlock other mechanisms. See, that's crazy. I don't know. I don't want to look up anything, but I don't want to sit here and, you know, in silence because I don't know. Are there any at all, any other secrets? Oh my gosh. Why did that not come out to begin with? Is that what was preventing these from moving? What in the heck is this? What could that mean? Literally a red herring, because that's annoying. It worked, but yeah, it was annoying. Now three up, one down. Huh? Down three, up one down. So I can maybe get a look at it unobstructed. I've got just one, and then just down. I
maybe. So it's saying this one's down 3. This one, this is up. I think. Yeah, I don't remember what side was what. I think it was the same. I'm sure this is boring to watch, and I'm sorry. Thing down 3 0 up 1 down. I don't know what that translates to. Let's get the bed out again. Let's go. So we've got 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this one is down and 1. This one says 1 and up. This one says up and 3. This one just says 0. This one also says down. From here, maybe? Take it off carefully. So this goes down 1. This goes up 1. This one's up 3. 1, 2, 3. This one doesn't move. This one, it just says down. Gosh, that... Okay, so you gotta put this on there, figure out each block has no more than two, so this was down and also pointed to one. One was also pointed to the second one and up. And so I had to remove it carefully, and from this position I had to move this much. And that's what allowed that to move. It gives me the ball over to here. Okay. Whoop, no, come back. Now this one is crazy. I assume that's the next piece. Right. Unless I got a ball over here, but no. I'm assuming something I need to get this ball over here. Unless I can do anything with these. I don't know what I'm doing. Wait. I can't even go anywhere. What's the point of this ball then? Seriously. Oh wait, these have shapes. Of course they do. I can see why the labyrinth drives people mad. Well, that moved because it can move, but not fully. Feeling things are shifting. Okay. I figured out
absolutely nothing. See, these turn, but to what end? I mean, we've got four lines that kind of line up to things, but not precisely. So square, star, circle. Where even is star? There is no star. So there's just square and circle. Is this definitely the next part? Can I move on to somewhere else? Can't do that yet. That rotates. I already did that, What about down here? I don't want to do a spin. But then, I don't know if my desk is stable enough. Ah, no, it won't spin. It won't rotate anyway. I'm gonna have to get all these to the outside. Yeah, there's it's not the balls or the marbles, there's wood blocking it, I think. I'll try. Yeah, see, my desk isn't stable, it isn't level. From them. It's this neat little stand. It's got like a sword. It looks like it's floating. It's just because it's a magnet. So there is still something stopping it. That's all I wanted to confirm. I wonder if this will give me a magnet later to complete that, because I don't know how else I would.
wonder what this is for. Cause sure, I can like open up the path all the way. But there's nothing on the other side. It's just like two perpendicular lines, so they don't really line up with anything. A circle, triangle, circle, triangle. Yeah, same. It would have to be like square and circle. So it's crosses, triangles, crosses, triangles. Circle, square, circle, square. Oh, there's the shapes. I'm crossing my fingers here. If this works, I will show you. Okay, and this has to go. Oh no, that's all right. And this one. That does not seem to be it. I don't know what the I don't know what this is supposed to refer to. Here, these are all open. I'll show you an example. So they're like semicircles. So if it's not straight, it blocks it. So I have to open it up so that it allows it to pass through. Each of these have a shape on the side that corresponds to one of these wheels. And I went through hoping that that's how it's supposed to go. Is so I oriented this the same way this is, and so on and so forth. That's that way. That's, oh, hang on. Okay, that's this way, that's this way, that's that way. So, I would hope that that would mean this ball could fall through freely, but it doesn't. Saying that that is where this flat side is. So if I want the flat side on the top, like this bottom row, I need to flip them the other way. Now if that's the case, that's going to be next level. So then the double is here. So let's flip this around. And the last one is this guy. Let's flip you around. Alright, let's take a look at that ball. I can see you. Go home. I don't know if this, like, it's like a resistance symbol. I don't know if that's supposed to tie anything together. I mean, I see it in various places. Like there and there. Kind of ties them together. I don't know what the point of that is. Or what the crosses and... We got square, triangle, circle. So, process of elimination either, because I'll be here forever.
same square. Is, oh boy. Like, I'm shooting in the dark, and my ideas are getting more and more out there. So, like, this is oriented square at the bottom, circle at the top, plus sign, triangle. Looking at this, is that saying that I should treat this like the square, that's the bottom? Well, no. Circle should be at the top. Oh, it makes no sense. I've got these tiny little wood splinters everywhere. Well, I think it's safe to say that this is the more difficult one of theirs. Or at least this part has just got me stumped. Farther. Okay. Why? Why did that fall farther? Okay. It's not pointing to square. Circle? Wait. Thing is this way.
That makes no sense.
So, I did the process of elimination for the first two. I saw the ball fall farther. And I'm even more confused. So this was this one. So I'm just like going this way and this way. As I don't know, that makes no sense. Whatever. Okay, let's take this. Yeah, I don't know. That makes no sense. You'd think I'd see a pattern now that these are in the right position. It's like square, cross, triangle, circle, cross, triangle, circle. Following that, if I did circle, triangle. Hate that, because I would want to come back, but
Maybe if we stick with the same. Or what if I do? So this these are opposite directions. It's the left, right. Left, right. So that's right. Through again? I don't think it did. It looks like it's about the same distance. Shifted it. See, I don't know. I don't get it at all. I mean, they're kind of, so if any pattern, it's going to be facing this way. So let's try. Okay, that worked. I don't get it at all. So this one is pointing up. That means the flat side is on back here. And the square, like I don't get it. I hate that I did that by process of elimination, but at least it's over with. Oh, this is a double. Oh boy. Oh, it goes to the other side too. It's gone. Where'd it go? Okay.
Oh, this is awkward.
Supposed to be. So let's get you back. There we go.
No.
Nope, get down. There we go. Okay. Just take a breath. Take a drink. I'm sorry, this just looks awkward. Okay. So we need to get it here. question is, how? Ah, okay, I see. Sure, this makes for riveting content. Now I need to. Oh well. Maybe don't lock you in place. That's because I need you right there. While you right there. Jeez.
Whoever thought this through is an absolute madman.
I'm not even gonna try to explain like all the steps involved.
There's definitely some three-dimensional
shifting happening here. Can I not get that? Oh, I can't. Oh wait, there it goes.
Okay.
Oh gosh. Oh, was that a mistake? No, it wasn't. Hopefully this part is almost over. Okay, there we go. Now it's gone. Okay, no, here it is. Okay. Now I have it here on this panel. Let me just show you the craziness that was this panel. There were like three levels. And then each of these also shifted in like two levels. And it was so each of these, that was crazy. This one seems a lot more simpler, so I believe I can move this all the way over. So we can get you in there. Okay, so that's in here. Well, oh, that's a pain. I'm gonna turn a little bit. Now I can use it to hopefully unlock this piece. Hopefully. Well, it says it's locked. Apparently not. Let's try this other one first. And that's as far as that goes. Anything.
Oh, gosh. I feel like I'm going to break it.
That has to be it, though, right? It's not budging at all.
See, it's even got like a lock symbol and then an unlock symbol.
Oh, that doesn't go any further. That's why.
The plastic has a cutout for this to rotate, and that's literally as far as that rotates.
So what am I supposed to do? Is that what this is for? No, I can't rotate any further than that. Do I need this other ball to... I probably need a ball there and a ball there. But how do I...
symbols are just for looks, or if they're actually like, oh yeah, this goes to here, pulls this lever for this over here. That all the way up, and now I have two. There we go. That's what I needed. Come on, draw back in there. Unlocked. This? Yes. And then it's saying to spin it. That
See, while... Oh, it worked. I got it.
Join the Scientia Club. I don't know how well this is gonna spin. This top. Let's see if I can get it more in view. There we go. All right. Well, that was a ride. Now, it actually says spin to join the scientia.club, .club being a website, a top level domain. So, scientia.club. Boom. And it's in German. Let me select the English option. Enter the number of circles you see on the spinning top to gain access. Oh, wow. Is it these or do I actually have to spin it? So it's like one, two. Okay, hang on. That is actually really neat. One, two, three, four, four? Number of circles. So is it each line? Is that what they're counting, a circle? Four? Yep, it was four. Cool. So it was counting the lines. Congratulations, you've become a member of the society. We're always glad to meet new enthusiasts who are eager to participate in new developments. If you have creative ideas, don't hesitate to get in touch with us. And who knows, maybe your idea will be our next creation. In the meantime, you can leave a message to our engineers about the experience with the Labyrinth Challenge. They will be glad to know they didn't try in vain building it. Well, considering I finished my last one, I think, right at an hour, it took basically 15 minutes to reassemble it. I think I started right at about an hour ago, so I'm gonna put a full 60 minutes as my playtime. Send. And I am on the leaderboard. That's pretty neat. Alright. I'm gonna put this back in. I'm not gonna leave it out. If it was a magnet or something, then yeah, I'd throw it up on my fridge, but alright, assembly. Oh gosh, this is gonna be just as tricky, isn't it? There we go. Okay. This is fine. I'm just gonna spin these around. Do I have to take the ball all the way backwards through? Oh boy. So this one might take me just as long. Come on. There we go. Okay. Got that in place. This is what's gonna take me a while. Okay. Oop. Oop. Where did you go? Here.
Oh, is this like a quick exit? I would love you if it was. If that's true, like to quickly reset it, that's so awesome. Like, the fact that they
not only thought about that, but built it into something.
Yeah, that's awesome. It has like a quick reset at the end. Maybe. I thought it did. If we move these all the way up, move this over. Oh, okay, maybe not. Maybe this was a trap. Because I can't move that any further by itself. The case, then I am already lost. Come on. There we go. Jeez. That's like a workout almost.
Please tell me these are still.
Oh, dang it. I moved these.
act. Of course you are. Oh, dang it. I did not. I didn't write that pattern down. Wait, was I supposed to put... Oh, don't tell me. Where'd that come out of? Where did you come from? Oh, there you are. Nope. What in the heck? Oh, there it is. You came from there. But where did you come from? Right here? Put this back in. I need both those balls there to unlock it. Unless I can. It's tapered. Okay. Okay, good. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Okay. We're just going to set you upside down while I refigure this out because I'm stupid. This one's all the way down. Shoot. Okay. No, I'm not gonna write that down again. Back to here, and this went all over the place. And if I had one of these when I was a kid, I'd be all over it. It would take me forever, but I would have been all over it.
There we go. Boom. Back into the start. So if I do this, does it lock in place? Cool, it does. I don't even know what's the top. I guess that is, because that's what opened. Jeez. Yeah, about another 13, 15 minutes to reassemble. I mean, it was fun. It was probably, while I did enjoy it, and it was extremely like this, I still have no idea how that side worked at all. It wasn't one of my favorites. I mean, I love all the boxes from them. This is probably my least favorite, but that's still a really high bar. I do enjoy the puzzle boxes and mechanics. Not crazy about the fine dexterity needed for getting balls to move, marbles to move inside of things. Not that I lack the skills necessary, it's just sometimes you kind of like you shake things over and over again, and it ends up being a little bit more repetitive and has a higher chance of irritating the solver. Irritating me. But with that being said, I still enjoyed it. And that is all I have, unfortunately. That's all they have. They have no other puzzle boxes like this, what they call escape room in a box. They have other little gift puzzle boxes, things like that, but nothing quite like this. They also have giant ones. I don't know if they still have them, but they had, for the Kickstarter, you had the option to get a standard size one or a giant one, which I think was quite a bit bigger, like a foot. Yeah, this was still pretty fun. If I had to pick a favorite, honestly, I think I would have to go with Captain Nemo's, I think that's what it was. No, it was Davy Jones's Locker. Just how it broke down into layers, and then you looked at the last, like the top layer, like almost like a compass, and follow the constellations. I just thought that was really, really neat, really cool. But yeah, if you want to check these out, I'm going to share the links again. Here are the puzzle boxes by iDventure. And then checking out. Sorry, I just was looking at my the wall of fame for this one. I'm on there. I'm about average. I don't know how some people beat this in like 30 minutes. I mean, this would be crazy dexterous. That's the word. So there's the link for the adventure, and I'll go ahead and share again the music that I listen to. Is by Lo-Fi Geek, is their YouTube channel. Lo-Fi, they have several, at any given time, several live channels where they just stream copyright free lo-fi chill music to listen to, relax to, focus to. That's how I found is music to focus to, like focus on work, because I can't listen to music with words or lyrics because it sort of breaks my focus.
But yeah, and then just one more shout out real quick, just because I love his channels, and if it weren't for his puzzle boxes and puzzle box series that he does, I never would have discovered these, or really puzzle boxes. But Chris Ramsey, magician on YouTube, just throwing his link out there. If you like watching puzzle boxes be completed, he has some incredible puzzle boxes that he does. Some people send custom puzzle boxes directly to him. And I say puzzle boxes, I mean, some are as big as, like, I wouldn't even have room for it on my desk here. Some are massive, like full cabinets, and they are several thousand dollars. And that's the only ones I really watch of his. I watch him solve puzzles, one-of-a-kind puzzles that I would never get a chance to solve. Otherwise, I would not want to watch spoilers. I wouldn't want to watch him. I think he does some of Adventure's puzzles. I wouldn't want to watch him solve it because these are affordable and easily attainable. Maybe you have to wait some time, but I could easily get another one and solve it for myself. And if I can solve it, if I get the chance to solve it, I wouldn't want to watch someone solve it. You know, it kind of defeats the purpose. So, but yeah, he has some incredible puzzles. I love watching his stuff. And of course, he's up out there, you know, nearing 6 million subscribers. So he has all the good hardware, you know, great cameras and camera angles. I apologize, mine. I don't know why it's so out of focus. It should be in focus. I don't know. I'll look into that. It's not like... Yeah, I don't know. But yeah, he's got great cameras. Like, his puzzle solving videos are easy. Like, he breezes through them. He's got multiple different angles he can bounce between. He's got a GoPro he straps to his head for in close, like, tight angles. And my GoPro is my angle camera, my top-down camera. So, other than that, I just have a webcam. Of course, I wanted to do this live. I didn't want to film it. I probably could have filmed it with a better camera. I think my phone's a better camera. But I wanted to do it live because I wanted a true, like, experience, you know, a live experience. So you saw me struggle, and boy, did I struggle. But yeah, check out those people if you're interested in similar stuff to this. I would love to do more. Unfortunately, I don't have any others right now. By this or any other company. There are some others I'm watching for, but I haven't bit the bullet and purchased any others yet. So until then, let me show you a little bit, one final time. These are all my puzzles by iDventure. These are all the puzzles by iDventure. In order, we did Schrodinger's cat, Captain Nemo's Nautilus, Davy Jones's locker, The Trial of Camelot, and Cambridge Labyrinth. And these are my puzzles. They too can be your puzzle. I don't have any like reference code to give you. Like, go to their website /me. Yeah, I can't help you with that. I just give you the website, and you can buy them yourself at full price. I'm sorry, but they're worth it. I backed the Kickstarter, so I'm sure I got them a little bit cheaper than retail. But they were still, it was worth it. Keep an eye out for them on Kickstarter. Find them on Kickstarter and follow them there for anything new.
I'll see if I can find them real quick and share that link as well. Yeah, right here. Boom. Follow them on Kickstarter. And you'll get notifications for any new puzzle boxes. The last two, these two, they called it Clash of Magic and Science. So these were a bundle. Same thing with, or no, these are separate, actually, it looks like. But these two were a bundle. So, yeah. Follow them. Keep an eye out for more. I know I will. Next ones I get, if it's another two pack. I like the two packs. So hopefully they'll do another set, another series. Until then, unless I find some others, I won't be able to do any more of this, but it's fun. I definitely like, I love puzzle boxes. I love to collect them. I love to be able to build them, but not there yet. Yeah. Until next time, until I stream something else, probably a video game. I like streaming non-conventional things, so if you come up with any ideas, let me know. But if not, I'll probably just be streaming a game. So, until then, thanks for watching, and